Slightly more challenging to program is the function median. Now the median of this list is the middle element of the sorted list, which in this case will be 2. Of course, if there is an even number of elements, let me just add one, the median isn't exactly defined. So let's say I pick either one of the two center ones. All the examples I'm testing with will have an odd number of elements. Okay, so let's not worry about the case where the list is of even length. Let's just make sure our code runs for an odd length. So this one is more complicated to program, and there's two hints. First, there's a function called sorted, and you can give it data, and the output of the function gives you a sorted list that's built into Python, so you don't have to worry about how to sort things. Luckily not. It'd be useful to assign this to a new list. And the way you do this, you just give it a name, say sorted data as data. And that gives you a sorted list. And the second thing to know is if you want to access any element in a structure like this or in a structure like this, you can do this using notation like this. Now, this is a tricky thing. This doesn't give you the third element in the list. It gives you the fourth. And the reason is each list is indexed starting with 0. So this list has 5 elements and the indices go from 0 to 4. So to go to get to the center element, you would have to use index number 2, and it gives you effectively the third element in the list. I apologize for this. This is all over computer science that the indices tend to run from 0 on, not from number 1 on, whereas in the English language, you use 1 as the first index. Some programming languages use 1, some use 0. Python uses 0. So you have to know this. With those hints, you should be able to fill in the gaps. Write your code over here. Return something, and if you print the median of this data sequence over here, then it should output you a 2, which is the median. So here's the code. To solve this, first make a new sorted list of the data, and then find the corresponding element in that list to return. And let's assume there's an odd number of items in the list, so things should always be fine.